Oh yeah, so we've cut already, have we? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So to see who goes first.
You have rock, paper, scissors right there.
Why do I? Yeah. I even got them out a moment ago when we were off camera. I don't even know what I'm thinking, man. You know what? Screw it. This one's mine, you pick yours. You gotta beat the paper tiger. Om nom 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 nom! T1 Glycerol is not sponsored by Troy. Alright.
Yeah.
This is a terrible hand.
I gotta keep this one.
I'll keep it.
Alright. Pass turn.
It only gets worse.
Oh no.
Oh no! Mr. Bill!
19.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, okay. The Magic Online Underground Sea. Are you using, what's it called? Magic.bluestones or whatever that proxy generator?
Yeah, probably.
Okay. Maybe the same one I ended up using. Hey, whatever works. This is super unsanctioned.
I have to look away.
You had yours over here, I think? Okay. Resolves.
Good.
Okay.
Dumbass.
Brainstorm.
Okay.
Good for it.
Oh, good. I got another freaking assist.
Fetch. I'm going to try to turn this card into Ancestral Recall.
Okay.
Get an island. Get a foil island. Because why not?
Oh, yeah.
Pimpin'.
Oh.
What's that, Oh, yeah.
Doobie 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 doobie.
Looks like you're probably high tide to me.
All these basics.
I can see where you're coming from, but I just played a Slippery Bogle. This is a homebrew. Pass turn. I can definitely see where you're coming from on that, though.
Dress?
You have two legal targets. Let me sort my hand for you. Curiosity, Spectral Flight, Island, Cathedral of War, True-Name Nemesis. Do you know what Nemesis means? We'll go with that shit. Having fun in the background over there. Oh, and you have the IDW promo.
Yes.
Nice. IDW is best promo. I mean, for duress, that's my favorite art.
I agree. Spectral Flight.
Okay. And I'll play reveal for the rest of it. All right. Because, I mean...
Crack a Delta.
Okay, if this were a competitive event,
no
you would
way.
Write it down, so...
I'm going to Inquisition True Name.
Okay, True Name is gone. Solid gone, baby.
Because I have no actual way to deal with it.
Well, outrace, I imagine. That's about it.
Yeah.
I would think you wouldn't have a way to... deal with Slippery Bogle either, though. It's a little slower, though.
It doesn't go. I joked around. And I can, if I had creatures, I could, you know, realistically block it.
But it's taunting you with its art. It's just doing that. Cabal therapy for it? Yeah. Okay. And then, however you had it. Think like that, right? Curiosity?
Yep.
Swing one, draw a card off the trigger.
17.
Pass turn?
16.
Cathedral. I only hit you for... Oh, yeah, yeah. I only hit you for two. Sorry about that. Yeah, that's it. So... You know, 8 turn clock. That's all.
What?
The joys of old school combo decks like this, where you can wait as long as you need to.
Brainstorm.
Yeah.
Oh.
I always shoot. I let him get it, and then I shoot him.
Do either of you guys want one, by the way?
No.
Fair enough. Apparently, I'm the one guy outside of that state that likes this. Oh, Brainstorm Fetch. Yeah.
The classic.
Ancestral Recall, man. Swing 3, 13, trigger, curiosity.
Is it what killed the cat?
Maybe, not yet, in a few turns. Pass turn. Yeah. Not cracking that fetch was maybe the difference between 4 turns and oh. Are we life or mana?
Life.
Alright. Force of Will, Counterspell, Slippery Bogle, Island.
That's a thing.
Yeah. So, double Counterspell back up. But you get a draw, so there's that. I mean, you know what you're drawing. Yeah,
yeah, I know. What...
I call bullshit.
Yeah, that's a thing. Can I sack your bubble? Is that cool?
I mean, there are cards that do that. If you run, what's it called, Innocent Blood? The 1 mana, each player sacks a creature. Yeah. I would actually be surprised if it were main board, but in the sideboard, I would not be surprised.
Oh, I knew it.
He knows it.
Yeah. We need to get you on the channel playing this at some point. That would be awesome.
Playing what?
Playing this. Oh. CSGO? You're on CSGO,
right?
No,
he's not playing CSGO. You don't play CSGO on the Xbox.
Oh, okay.
Is it on Xbox?
No. He's playing Call of Duty.
Oh, I have no idea. I'm not seeing
you
it.
You play CSGO?
I have it. That game makes me so salty, man.
Yeah. That's a good way of
sure does.
Especially when they, I was DMG, and then the new patch came out that redid all the scaling on the rankings.
Yeah.
And I ended up back in Nova 1, and I'm just like, well, fuck this game.
If you do videotaping, you might want to put explicit.
Oh, yeah.
Very
in SFW.
Yeah.
Or in SFL. Not safe for life.
Counterspell?
Not safe for anyone, really.
All right, it doesn't matter for right now, but future reference, you actually don't have to name it until you... until it resolves.
If you are sensitive...
I mean, this is what I would probably do anyway. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll counterspell it. Even if you hadn't named it yet, I probably would just counterspell right there. Yeah, duress and cabal therapy, that's where it's at. I actually think Cabal Therapy is the most skill-intensive card in the game.
Really?
That or Brainstorm, but Cabal Therapy, especially blind, requires you to have knowledge of like every deck you could possibly be playing against. Yeah, maybe it's the format, not the game itself, but a blind Cabal Therapy is very tough. A Brainstorm only requires you to really know your deck most of the time. Yep.
Crack.
Yep.
What
the fuck?
It's my teammate.
Oh. Yeah, he's
gonna be a dude. Technical term, douche. You were the one that told me on Domination with the little, you know, the blunderbuss. They all lay down on the first flag. Just
Yeah, I tried to play that Xbox a minute ago and like...
Really?
I couldn't even look in a general direction.
Mm.
I forgot how to use a controller, apparently.
Oh. I feel you on that. Oh my god. Yeah, this one I let resolve.
That would be amazing if
I wonder what you're...
Yeah.
Yeah, that seems pretty good here. Because if I force it, I lose two cards. And a life.
Yeah.
And that one life probably isn't relevant, but it could be the difference between 9 and 10 storm.
Okay.
Nope. Fuck it.
Two tears in a bucket. We come in with the ruckus.
Combat? Three? Curiosity trigger? Oh, excuse me. Yeah, three. That's right.
Wait, no. Yeah, that trace back had a team kill. That's what it was. But.
Future reference.
But? I don't know. I think it's a future. Oh, yeah.
Yiddish? Or Hebrew? Or I don't know. It may be.
It's because the Eagles are doing work, man.
Not enough. How many cards in hand?
Four.
Alright.
Man, why don't you play Yawgmoth, Will?
Pass turn. Yawgmoth. Oh, joy.
I've been watching too much Vintage. I'm sorry.
Hey, that's good, man. The card may be just a little bit.
Yeah.
Past in Flames is...
Close enough. Yeah. It's June turn.
Not as good, Brainstorm? But... Yeah. Here we go. Yeah, Brainstorm Fetch.
I'm sorry. No shit. This isn't Ponder.
It happens.
Crack.
Yeah, there we go. I'll roll you down. Now that it's a two-turn clock regardless. And yes, you're right, the cathedrals are doing some work. I may not be quick enough, though. Pretty sure I'm not quick enough. Slippery Bogle. Why? Okay, there's the red mana, finally. Gotta be an LED in there somewhere. I've given you all this time to work through your deck. There's got to be something in there. Yep. Oh, the Magic Online LED. I'm sorry. Well, beep. Yeah, that resolves. That resolves. Is the last card Infernal Tutor?
Yes.
It is. All right. So Storm is three. No, Storm is four. It's Brainstorm. Yeah. Sorry. I was just counting on. Okay. Yeah.
Response. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, while you hold priority, making, let me guess, red and black?
You guessed it.
Okay, so three red, three black in the pool.
Didn't have to sack those in response.
It's force of habit.
Yeah.
Yeah, without any other cards in hand, you're right, it doesn't have to, but, yeah, fair enough.
Hey guys, let's play this team!
What is Demonic Tutor gittering? What am I saying? Yeah, you're at five right now. Gee, I wonder. I haven't seen any rituals hit the yard, though. So.
Yeah.
That's kind of a problem.
Well, no, I have plenty of mana.
Mm-hmm. He has six floating. One, two out.
I got one!
I have eight mana realistically.
Suck it, you gypsy scum!
Oh my goodness. So I'm assuming that it's...
Oh, there's the second round.
Past in Flames, and then you use the Underground Sea to try to find... like a Brainstorm, maybe, to try to find a writ, and then you go from there. Although, once Past in Flames is cast, you know, new cards that are added to the graveyard don't get flashback until you cast it again.
Could always go a Nazir.
Oh my god.
Could live the dream, man.
Oh my god. Yeah, you could. That you're at 6 life though, so I guess I wouldn't recommend.
I only have
it.
A 5 drop in the deck. Come on, man.
Yeah, that's fair. I don't recommend it actually.
I mean, I think the most you can store out for it now is 8. Right?
Well, even if he just goes for 8, he drains me for, you know, yeah. 16. And that's not nothing.
But I have no cards in hand. What do I get? I think I just actually just get Dancing Flames.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is called the value of Passing Flames.
I guess you could, like, Passing Flames, Tutor, Tendrils.
Well,
you gotta
kill the queen. I agree with, so if you Passed in Flames Brainstorm, and you exile one of your Brainstorms because flashback, you'll still have another one that you can use later for when you flashback Passed in Flames. So I can definitely see that. That makes sense. Demonic Pact. Oh, that makes me happy. That makes me happy to see. Storm decks, if nothing else, can play that card. Oh, that makes me so happy. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that, but I had to. Yeah, it happened. Oh. Not really Demonic Tutor, but when it resolves, it's 5 mana plus 3. It's, yeah. Kind of Demonic Tutor. Yeah, okay, so how are we paying for that? There's
2 red.
2 red, 2 black?
Yeah.
Okay, so red and black still in the pool.
Well, it's one of those things, it's sort of like, you know how you have to stop jig on a tabletop?
Yeah.
Same principle. Keep going.
Ah!
So you just have to break
it. Oh no! Mr. Bill!
Ah!
Bitch!
Oh!
Fucked up! You fucked up.
Now you fucked
up!
Now you fucked up!
Calm down, John. Calm down.
Yeah, I immediately give you kudos just for playing this deck because it is much more complicated than, for instance, what I'm playing. I don't know if it's the most complicated deck in Legacy. I think that might be High Tide. I agree. Brainstorm. But mad respect for running it. So still black and red floating with Lotus Petal out. Have you played a land drop this turn? It was Volcanic, right?
Yes. Okay. I fetched into it.
And so Brainstorm makes Storm 7 because it was
this
Brainstorm,
difficult!
Lion's Eye, Iris, Pastor, Infernal Tutor, Past in Flames,
just fire.
Brainstorm.
Just don't
so
stop
7.
Fire, Josh. It's gonna be okay.
This is the hardest thing I've ever done.
I need rituals.
That's what she said.
I'm trying to get an interaction with too much.
Did you just shuffle off a Brainstorm?
Don't work. Oh no, but I'm not having a reload.
It happens, dude. It's okay. Ladies and gentlemen, he does not do this very often.
I do it all the time. Shut up. No, I can see.
You can see?
Yeah.
Oh, you just didn't get what you needed anyway? I'm sorry.
He didn't have the mana for it.
I'm sorry.
I was thinking it was a ponder.
Okay, so that was, if you had gotten it that turn, that was just bad luck, because spoiler alert, I did not have the counterspell, nor would I have drawn into it. If you had gotten it right there, you would have had it. No doubt.
Not having rituals is what?
Yeah.
Hurt me a little bit.
Yeah, you're right. The 2 Lion's Eye Diamonds, I figured was going to be enough mana, but like you said, you didn't have any already played, so that'll do it. I'm going to cut it for just a sec.
just let Aaron take it.
That's the best part, when he just laughs right after it.
That's like my
egg. I'm a lot hotter than your egg. I'm just kidding.
I don't know, later and take it and find out.
Wow! All right, so your choice to be on the player draw? I'm assuming.
Play.
Yeah. In Legacy, are there any decks? Manless Dredge. That's pretty much it, right? That wants to be on the draw? Maybe Miracles in the Mirror?
Oops
wants to be on the draw?
No.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure about that.
Oops.
I can see it, though. I'm still deciding. Sorry. No, I think I have to keep it. Okay, let's try it. I'm on the draw, so that makes this a little easier to keep. Alright. Ponder.
Ponder, preordain, brainstorm.
Yeah, brainstorm I can understand waiting on, but yeah.
Preordain,
yeah, there we go.
I will bottom both.
I had an epiphany the other day. Ancestral Recall is so good that a card that requires you to put two cards back is also restricted in Vintage. A card that lets you look at three but only draw one is restricted in Vintage. You have to get all the way down to Preordain before you're not restricted anymore. That's amazing to me. Oh, and also Treasure Cruise is restricted.
Yes. That was an oops. They're like, oh, it's fine.
I think that they underestimated how easy it would be to get that Delve 7 in. If they had just printed it a little bit higher, you know, 8 or 9, I think it would have been okay.
Or they restrict fetches.
Well, yeah. Yeah, with fetches, it's just, whoa, it's way too easy. I don't know. I haven't run the maths on it yet, but I think it might be the case that you would be perfectly all right if you had... Ooh, this is an interesting choice. We'll fetch and go to 19. If you had it be blue and 8. Here we go. Well, okay, there we go. Get the foil because I'm pimping, I guess. Why not, right? I will cast Slippery Bogle and I will pass the turn. Yeah, that's a legacy card.
By that point, I'm about half lit.
It's great against some decks. This is not one of those decks. Not at all.
I'm lit!
Oh, and by the way, FYI, you two, we are not sideboarding. Neither of us sideboarded.
Mainly because I don't have a sideboard.
Yeah. I have a lot of sideways answers to you. I don't really have anything. I have Stifle. That's about the only card that, like, Stone Dad gets you. But even then, you have a lot of discards, so that's not saying too much. Sorry. Okay. I'll roll you to 19 while you shuffle.
Thank you.
No problem.
I think every now and then just decide.
They're all clumped together, aren't they? Mm-hmm. There's only two of them in here.
I'll do it.
See in the underground. I will then pay two life.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, may I look at your graveyard for just a quick second? Ponder, or Preordain, Ponder, Polluted. Okay.
Triple P.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Triple P. The name of a...
Hey, that's what we call my ex.
Rapper? Oh, Triple P?
Triple
G. Triple G. Oh. Now there's a G.
Now I get what you call it.
Here's my land. I have no creatures. I have double curiosity, spectral flight. I have my, that's my one counterspell. That's my cantrip.
I don't know how anybody can slide
working
on this game.
Yep.
And I'll keep it revealed, because I know that if this were a competitive event, I may have said this last round, but you would write it down if this were competitive.
Let's see if I can get that force wheel out of your hand.
Ooh. Yeah, if you had not said that, I still would probably let you resolve it. Yeah. The only other thing you go for is curiosity, and if I two-for-one myself on that, I think it might actually be worth it. I'm operating under the assumption that you didn't just say, let me get that force of will out of your hand.
Let me get that force of will
out
of your hand.
That kind of gives it away.
I may not call force of will. I might just be trying to bait the counter. Because I could go off next turn.
Yeah, well, you're taking the... It's either Force of Will or Curiosity. Those are your only choices. Curiosity, you can take two, and they're draw spells. Force of Will, you take the counterspell. So that, like you said, you can go off. I let it resolve.
Curiosity.
Yeah.
Pass turn.
Mm-hmm. I think you probably would have named Force of... Well, no, you had access to my hand. Brainstorm?
Seems good.
It precludes being able to play Spectral Flight this turn is the issue.
Get out of here, Rockbuster. I didn't realize you could shoot from down there.
Alright, so because it's Brainstorm, I'm about to hide my hand. Is that okay?
It unlocks over time.
I mean, yeah.
Like kills or avoiding...
No.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay, so what I was doing there unintentionally was, you know I'm going to fetch,
yeah.
So I was about to start the shuffle already, but that was dumb of me. Okay, here we are. Stuff to do. Well, that was pretty bad. Technical term. Pretty bad. Okay, but I am going to shuffle anyway. So, Luda Delta, go to 18. Shuffle them away.
He's hacking, that's why his number is a different color.
Well, yeah, I was getting a little bit ahead of myself. Sorry about that. Play another Pimpin' Island.
That's why we play.
Yeah.
To get better.
You're right. You're 100% right. Also, you notice the theme with my lands?
They're foil?
Not just that, well, not all of them are foil, but all of them are this art. All of my islands are this art. Because I am 13 years old.
I was playing the Orc Smile Revolve.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm that guy. I'm that guy. Anyway, on that note,
we take the server over, right. And then some of the guys are getting greedy, and they're like, "All right, we'll attack everybody on the server. You all have to pay."
Oh, pass turn.
Resources, or we don't like you.
No attacks.
No attack. Oh wait.
They were just dicks. So like,
I'm sorry. Okay. Yeah. No attacks. No attacks. I missed it. We're being casual. Like, that was just me. I would not do that in a competitive match. That was me getting caught up in the conversation and whatnot. You sure?
So we could, like,
okay.
This, is like,
this guy is that awesome.
He's like,
subscribe to him on YouTube.
Yeah.
Shit. Like, okay.
Let me get that force wheel out of your hand, bro.
Yeah.
It took us 3 days to set up, and we
yeah.
We
there's forcible. I don't think I would force that. I can't.
Damn.
All right. So spectral, unstable, cathedral.
Okay.
Last round he tried to go off, but wasn't able to make it. He didn't get a ritual at any point in the game. Otherwise, he would have had me.
Storming the brains.
Mm-hmm.
But it was another custom server, so it was like one guy that owned the server.
Right.
And so he was like, nah, you guys can't be in this. Like, you're going to run off all my people.
So good.
Sonic,
like,
that's no good.
Right.
And we were like running everybody off his server. So
okay. So where's the fetch lands?
Ah.
Oh.
That's what I was
like
digging for, man.
I hear you on that. I do
that
indeed. Cathedral?
So I'm just like, I guess we're just too good, guys. It was hilarious. Let me get a drink.
I have threshold.
Yeah, you do, do you?
I'm just like, I'm done for a while.
Right.
And admittedly, that matters for Cabal Ritual.
Might have spent like 30 hours in 3 days.
It's like a lot of places to work around.
Do you got dices?
Burn out on that fucking
shit. I do not, I'm afraid. Although there are dice over there that he'll let us use.
I spent 30 hours sitting.
Do you have some D6s I can use?
I mean,
if it's Storm, probably 2. Or a D10. One of the two. No. Oh, he may need it for mana. Never mind. He may need it for mana.
I'll make it work.
Alright. Spectral Flight?
Yep.
Swing.
Go 12.
Yep. Pass turn?
Wonder what I'm drawing.
Yeah.
Not
bet
mana.
You know.
Dark Ritual?
Oh god. Time to go off.
Go from three...
So...
To one?
Yeah. Alright, like six. You said, you have Threshold. So, yeah, 1, 6, yeah. So you're at 6 mana. 6 black. Alright, LED. Do you mind if I look at your graveyard?
Yeah, quickly? That's fine.
Okay.
And this is also in the graveyard as well.
Yeah, yeah. It's resolved, of course, since Lion's Eye Diamond's on the field now, having been cast. Alright. Where's the tutor?
4 black. Tutor. Your response.
Alright, so let me just play this out really quickly. Infernal Tutor, Past in Flames, Dark Ritual, Cabal Ritual, Infernal Tutor, Tendrils of Agony, any other spell. You have more than enough mana to do all of that, so I can save you.
Okay.
Yeah, I can save. Plus, you had one blue open, so you just play a Brainstorm for the sake of getting 10 Storm, and you got me.
Wait,
you don't even need 10 Storm, you need 9 Storm. Yeah, so that's that game. Here we go. Hoping that the camera doesn't die on me.
Yeah.
In just a sec. It could. Who knows? Hopefully we'll be able to get this match in at least.
Seems good.
Ho 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 ho.
You sleeping?
Terrible bad. Actually,
that's not as bad as mine.
It's so...
Not a matter of doubting.
It's almost utterly unkeepable, but I think... I have to.
I don't see this doing.
I think I have to.
I'm mulling.
You're mulling? Oops.
And the two cards that are in my hand are not Brainstorms.
Oh, no, they're not. Okay.
This,
that makes me feel a little bit better.
Way out.
But yeah, you played that correctly, letting me decide before you decide. Yeah, so let me show off the hand while you're doing that. I don't know if showing off is quite the right term. Okay, so there's this. And this, which is the only reason I'm keeping it. Actually, I guess you're also a reason, but you're also...
That's it.
2 blue and colorless. But she only has 1 blue and 2 colorless. I'm guessing.
That fucker, I just laughed.
Yeah, this card is... I want to see this go off. It's amazing. It won't be enough, I know. But... If it increases a storm by 2, effectively, that may be what it takes. Or increases his storm need by 2.
Amethyst of whatever it is.
Thorn of Amethyst?
Yeah.
Not that one. Oh gosh, that increases your storm need by...
A lot.
Technically it doesn't increase your storm need, but the mana it takes? Oh god. It's the non-creature version of Thalia. I actually do run that as a 1-up in the sideboard in my Eva deck. You can tutor it up with Enlightened Tutor. It's I have one main board card that like shuts down Eva, shuts down Storm in that deck, and so it's a sideboard card I can tutor up to. What do you say?
I mean, it's not good, but it's better than 5.
At least you get a scry and a draw. Keep it? Okay. Here we go.
Yeah.
Pass turn.
Crack.
Okay. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. It's a go.
Get swamped.
Yeah, I don't really think there is anything else I could. Honestly.
I mean, you know I'm not running Blood Moon. At worst, I'm running back to basics, so I think you're fine.
I ain't really, it's just like
I need to work. I have actually considered back to basics in this deck. There's only one non-basic in my deck. Well, four copies of
I'm only
one.
Running two Underground Seas and one Trop, not Trop, Volcanic.
I made this deck with the intention of building a
I mean, early game is not really a big deal.
A budget legacy deck, I suppose? If you're going to be a budget legacy deck, well, first of all, be one color, obviously. Second of all, I guess be blue? Force of Will is the one exception to that rule.
Yeah.
But other than that, everything else in the deck is both powerful and cheap. Brainstorm, Ponder, Preordain if you're running that, Counterspell, Force of Will being the exception. Slippery Bogle's not too expensive. Invisible Stalker. You haven't seen Invisible Stalker yet. It's in here.
Well, now that you mention it, we're going to play a real intensive game of Magic.
All right, what do you name? Blind Cabal Therapy. This is why I think it's the most skill-intensive card, at least in Legacy, if not Magic.
2, 4, 6 cards in hand.
6 cards, yeah.
We will go with the Counterspell.
Counterspell? Like actual Counterspell? The name Counterspell? Okay. Brainstorm, Force of Will, Curiosity, Umezawa's Jitte, Spectral Flight, True-Name Nemesis.
True-Name was going to be my second guess, but...
Sorry. Because of what I said earlier when I was talking to the camera.
No, just because that's probably the hardest card for me to deal with.
Fair enough.
But right. Didn't get
and
there.
And I'll play Revealed, of course. I considered playing Brainstorm in response there, just in case you named Brainstorm, but I thought you were more likely to name Force of Will. Yeah. And there's no point in playing the Force of Will if you're naming Force of Will, because then I'll just 2-for-1 myself, yeah. Unless I need to hide the information, and I don't think I do.
Honestly, going into the blind, you should almost always call Brainstorm, but it's a fun game.
I usually name Force of Will going into the blind, but I can see a case for Brainstorm. Absolutely.
Come on. Come on. Yeah. Come on. That's not working with you.
It's
giving them to you.
40.
28
apiece.
Brainstorm?
Mana leak. 0 mana mana leak. Alright, so I am about to pick up these cards if you don't mind.
Yeah.
If you need to like write them down or memorize them,
I know
go
what
for
you,
it.
I already
21.
Okay.
I have a feeling I'm probably not going to win this game. I just hope you don't draw any more mana.
Well, if I didn't, I would probably concede right here, because then I would be drawing 2 cards that I knew were not mana, and then there's no way I'm winning. So, you know at least that much.
Question is, did you get the fetch?
Is there going to unban Death Rite?
Jitte?
And Blood Rite. Yeah, I feel it in my heart.
I don't know about...
That's what they're going to unban.
Jitte.
And fetch, yeah. Of course. And actually, you know what? We're getting a foil. Because every time I fetch, if I don't have a foil, I'm getting a foil.
The hardest thing I find in the world, like, you'll have, like, 3 or 4 of these, mm-hmm. but when you actually want to get a playset of a land, they're so hard to find.
Oh, yeah.
Because, well, like, you have to look for Foil Island, and then Foil Island, like, Innistrad number 136 or whatever.
And admittedly, if you don't have all of the same art and foil or not foil of a given card, then if your opponent Gitaxian probes you or Cabal therapies you and you accidentally play the wrong one, that can give information. Exactly. I see some players will like turn their card upside down if the opponent has seen it before, or they won't do what I just did and reveal everything. But we're playing casually, so whatever. Alright.
This is going to be a quick game.
Vocal.
Feel it on my
back. How many fetches do you usually play, Kevin?
Me?
8.
Too many.
Yeah,
enough.
8, actually.
6 to 8 is a good number, yeah.
Brainstorm?
Yeah. I'll spoil. I'm running 6 in this deck. Probably should go to 8. I think 6 is about the minimum for this kind of deck. I don't have any delve spells, though. So that disincentivizes me to run more, I guess. I mean, this is basically a tempo deck. But unfortunately, yeah, and you're cracking.
Yep.
I'll roll you down. You do your thing.
Getting the underground.
In your deck, I don't think that the fact that they're hexproof, or in the case of True Name, protection, I don't think that shuts down any cards in your deck. I don't know if that makes you a favored match against me. Because you have duress and cabal therapy to hit my counter spells, but at least it's not, you know, you cards like lightning bolt, swords to plowshares, abrupt decay, they're not blank against me. Whereas when he plays Shardless Bug, I'm gonna, you know, blank cards like dismember and abrupt decay.
Yeah. I forgot I was looking for a land.
Although, because he's Shardless Bug, he also has Liliana, which is very, very troublesome for me to deal with.
Yeah, because usually you don't have more than, hypothetically, two on the field.
Yeah. That's a card I don't know exactly how to deal with in this deck. I think I do. I have one sideboard card I'm going to bring in for it. It stifle. But other than that, I'm not entirely sure. Oh, you didn't go for the Volk.
I'm so greedy, Lyle.
And I don't mind you hearing about that, by the way.
Put in your extra two Lilianas.
If I had a Flusterstorm that was not proxied, I would certainly have it in the sideboard. I mean, there are only a few cards in this deck that are actually proxied. The Force of Wills and the True Names, and I think that that's it. Everything else is actually a real card. Alright. Ponder? Duress! Well, you already saw the hand, but I played a Brainstorm.
Yep.
Pretty sure I know what you name here. Resolves. Spectral Flight, Umezawa's Jitte, Curiosity, Force of Will, Cathedral of War. So here's the one you can't name.
So you put back True Name.
I put back True Name, yeah. I'm assuming you can't deal with a given creature in this deck. You don't have Golgari Charm, I'm assuming.
No.
Or, I don't know, Toxic Deluge.
It's one of them sideboard.
Oh.
It's a thing. Deluge for one.
You're right. You're absolutely 100% right. The 3-mana Wrath spell. All right. So what do you think is the card to pick here?
Jitte.
I agree with that 100%. Even if, I mean, it could deal more damage or it could increase the storm count, the requirement for storm. And yes, I know I'm being picky about this graveyard here, letting just the name and not the art also be revealed.
Last turn.
Okay.
Well, I mean, if I have extra land, then yeah. But...
Oh, I'm tapped too long.
I could go for more power by playing the Spectral Flight, but I think that I want more cards with Curiosity. Swing for two.
16.
Trigger, draw a card.
Also, me not knowing that you have the two extra cards you've drawn this turn.
Exactly, yeah. That's
it
also
gives you the Force of Will option, assuming that you didn't draw any other blue cards.
All other things being equal, you know I have Force of Will at the very least.
Yeah.
So, another discard spell is probably required to go off. Pass turn.
That's a thing.
Ooh, yeah, that's a...
Pretty?
Yeah, it resolves.
I'm really bad.
I'm not forcing that.
What's the deal with... What's your path?
I would have to have an abundance of counter spells to force a little something, or to force something like Creep.
I mean,
I
already clogged up the ground, like, what do we pack?
Brainstorm.
I love
it. You have not played a land this turn?
Nope.
Yeah, of course you haven't. Resolves.
That's not good.
I'm telling you, YouTube, I have mad respect for someone who can play a deck like Ant. Yep. Seems good. Judging by the art, we're actually playing on Magic Online. We're in the Matrix, man. We're in the Matrix.
That puts me to 50.
Ponder, preordain? Tell me it's Ponder, so that we can shuffle off of that.
That's what I would drop.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm totally behind this.
Nope, it's a pass.
I love it. I think, man, that thing's just like... Yeah, I mean, everybody keeps doing weird shit with their graveyard here lately. Yeah.
He's not wrong. He's not wrong.
It's literally just a free exonerated graveyard.
Yeah.
Leyline of the Void?
No, Pajuka Bob.
Spectral Flight?
Yep.
Combat? Swing 4?
Go to 11.
Trigger Curiosity?
What the fuck is you gonna lie? Provoke it, Command. Exile your Grave Talker? I was like, what would you do if somebody provoked, commanded, and exiled your Grave Talker with Pajuka Bob at instant speed?
Wow.
I mean, I would just look at him. It's like, what did you do? Like, why?
What did you
do? Why would you, sir, are evil? Like,
why are
thank
you,
dick.
You're like, why are you playing this in Legacy? I was trying to go off a tendril.
Oh, God, in Legacy?
That's not a thing. That doesn't exist. They'd be like, Dramogus Command? And you're like, I don't know. I'm pretty sure I should counter that.
Or are you talking about Tarkus Command?
No, the one who just put land in play.
Tarkus.
Is that Tarkus? Yeah.
Yeah.
Tarkus Command can be played.
It's not play an additional land this turn. It's put a land into play.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Which is funny because when you do that, you put a planes in and then pass the shit.
Storming of the Brain?
Like, oh.
Wait, what?
Three cards in hand? Four?
Four.
Four.
You.
Resolves.
Stop that board.
Yeah.
Solid. Yeah, 22 lines, but should be plenty of
this. Gitaxian Probe paying 2 life. That puts you to 8, right?
9.
9? I'm sorry, you were at 11.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've only got 2.
I think I have to. So it is Force Blue Card. It's Force Unstable Mutation, Misty Rainforest.
Nobody ran that shit forever. I used to have
draw.
A shit ton.
Yep.
And then all of a sudden everybody
were,
started.
And they were dollar.
What I'm gonna draw?
They weren't shit.
Yeah.
Come on, third.
All right. Which one do you pick? Gee, I wonder.
Not the Force, so well.
Unstable Mutation?
Yeah.
Ooh. Well, actually, that does make sense, because if you're going off this turn, Force of Will is useless without another blue card. So, that actually does kind of make sense, if he's going off this turn.
Nope.
No?
I'm not going off this turn. I don't think I can win.
I tell you what, Brian's little mill deck last night? That thing was brutal.
This puts on... It's still 2 turns regardless.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So
so you're taking the power away.
Yeah.
Okay.
Lips.
Lips, yeah.
Well, you know that I have Force of Will open now. And I'm assuming you're not running Stifle, but I'm not even going to run the risk. I'm going to play a basic here, just in case.
I've got a blue open.
You do, you do. Swing for a 4.
Go to 5.
Trigger. Draw a card.
Love these guys. Hate them.
I don't even want to take a chance at that.
Yeah,
I love it.
Just in case I'm wrong. I will pass the turn. So I didn't play a Cathedral last turn.
Think about getting rid of these.
Which means that unless I draw into Cathedral or another pump spell,
no,
you still have another turn.
Not really. I mean, I got Rusted.
Lines are?
Oh god. Do I need to start keeping track of Storm?
I mean, this is more out of desperation, really.
Oh yeah. Resolves?
Lines are?
Okay. Resolves?
I really like to have
Dark Ritual?
Yeah.
Resolves? 3 black?
Dark Ritual?
Maybe a dismember, like 4 path or something.
I mean, 5 black.
Or maybe...
Storm, black mana.
Passive Flames?
So, Storm, you want 2 Storm Silence, that's cool.
Yeah.
Counterspell?
Do it.
So six, storm is six. Because it counts spell like cast as well.
Do you have spell silence?
Two.
I had all
yeah, yeah, that's true.
I suddenly got bought out like
red.
Are you hellbent? Holy shite. There's no infernal tutor. Okay.
It's
okay.
Out of desperation.
I'm gonna take a let's do it. Let's do it. So you're popping it for three red, two black. Which exactly drains you out.
13.
Okay, let's do it. You're at 7. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna roll it up. You know, actually, let's do this correctly.
Black.
I agree, 100%. After all, you still have blue open. Okay, what are you naming?
Force of Will.
Forcible's gone. Roll your storm up to 8. Alright. Here we go. What do you got? Okay. Alright, so give me just a quick sec. 1, 4. And then 3, 5. Am I, or 3, 6.
Yep.
Excuse me. 3, 6. And in doing that, you've gotten your storm up to lethal. So storm doesn't matter anymore. Storm does not matter. I have only lands in hand, so that means that you have 6 black and potentially blue left.
Yeah. The question is, do I brainstorm or preordain?
Ooh.
Have you seen what risk?
Can you flashback?
If it was already in your grave.
I have Storm of Silence.
Yes, because that is not an alternate cost. It's like with Delve. You can flashback a spell with Delve and still pay cards from the graveyard. So yes, you may Gitaxian Probe me.
Alright, I'll go to 3.
Okay. You see the cards in my hand still, of course.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Did I play a land this turn?
I don't believe so. I think...
No.
I don't think so, no. No, because you had Underground last turn, and then you played a Brainstorm and fetched. So, there we go.
That helps out a little bit.
Okay. You're right, it does. Preordain is good. I mean, obviously, you... Okay, I'm F6 right now. I'm F6. If you don't kill me this turn, you're dead. But... Okay, so Storm is yes. Your Storm is yes at this point. If you find a Tendrils of Agony with the mana to cast it, then you win.
Pretty.
All right, and so we're still at 6 black in the pool. Did you find a Tendrils?
Nope.
Okay.
I'll storm the brains.
All right. Here it comes. Oh, we're even revealing
once
it.
Once they're broke in.
Oh.
It's been on there for a little over a year now.
Oh. Honestly, I think that could do it. So if you cast Dark Petition, you go to 1 mana and then gain 4, or gain 3 and go to 4 black mana, and then you get Tendrils, right?
Yep.
Is that how that works?
Yep.
Okay, so that's game then. You get... Let me make sure that's correct.
These were the cards that I drew off Brainstorm.
Yes. All right, so just to make absolutely positively sure, he's at 6 black mana after he casts Brainstorm off Underground Sea. He finds Dark Petition, casts it for 5, goes to 1, and then goes to 4 because of Spell Mastery, which we definitely have, right? We have... Brainstorm Duress, so we have Spell Mastery. So you go to 4 black mana, and play the Lotus Petal, again, whatever. But what matters is that he can cast Tendrils of Agony using the 4 black mana. And then Storm's May for, what are we at now, like 16?
Something stupid.
Something stupid like that, yes. If we were playing sideboards, I may have an answer right now. I may have Gravedigger's Cage, I may have... Maybe I'd side in Ravenous Trap. Spell Pierce. Stifle. But because we're not, I do not. This is game one, effectively. So, once again, one turn away. Good job, my friend. Mad respect for you playing a deck that's as complicated as that. I really, really have respect for you.
I need to play it more to get better at it, honestly.
Nothing wrong with that. That's a good thing to admit, admittedly. It was a really good thing to admit. If this deck were not running Cathedral of War, but were instead running Wasteland, I would run Days in here too. But because I don't have the mana denial that Wasteland gives, I don't think it's worth it running Days.
Wasteland's gone down a good bit.
I have Wasteland actually in another deck. I just don't think that it's as good in this deck. Just because my creatures are so weak without something like Cathedral of War.
Give you that extra reach.
Yeah, and with Unstable Mutation, it's a lot of power over the course of the game, but it can actually kill your creature if you don't have another pump to it, like Exalted, like Spectral Flight. It can actually end up killing your creature. So because of that, I've been running Cathedral, but I could exchange it for something like...
Yeah.
Like Wasteland.
That's my sideboard.
Yeah.
That's all I have for right now.
None of which do jack all against me. I'm pretty sure.
I mean, I could probably bring in like one or two for your equipment or your enchantments.
I do have an Umezawa's Jitte, so they do something against that potential.
Excuse me.
Potentially. But yes, it otherwise doesn't do very much, admittedly. Other than that, what do you think you might, since you already have Duress and already have Cabal Therapy in, do you have sideboard, what, Thoughtseize? I'm actually not sure what a Storm sideboard looks like. I should know.
It would honestly probably be just the Abrupt Decays, because I know most decks have Graveyard Hate, such as Grafdigger's Cage.
Yeah.
Just so I can help break through that. I mean... Grafdigger's Cage doesn't stop Storm, but it does restricting, like...
Yeah, it stops Past in Flames. Yeah. That's the reason I bring it in. That's the only thing it really stops, but without Past in Flames... I know you can still go off. Yeah. I've seen Storm go off without Past in Flames, but it's tough. It's really tough. All right, we'll see you later.